Disclaimer: we hope that the information obtained from this video will help you participate in making informed decisions about your care with your provider. This information is provided for public education purposes only and is not intended to substitute for the manufacturer's directions or a consultation with a healthcare professional. Always seek advice from your qualified health provider with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Never disregard professional medical advice or delay in seeking it because of what you learned from this video. We do not assume any legal liability or responsibility for the accuracy, completeness, or usefulness of any information, apparatus, product, or medical condition described. Hi, my name is Rebecca Nguyen.
And my name is Sarah Shapiro.
And we are pharmacy students at the University of California, San Francisco. Today, we'll be explaining how to use a monitor to check your blood glucose, also known as blood sugar.
Blood glucose monitoring is important to manage your diabetes and meet your blood glucose goals. It can help you determine how eating different foods, taking medications, and daily routines can affect your blood sugar levels. First, let's review the tools and supplies you will need.
Here is a glucose monitor. These are test strips which go in the meter. This is a Lancet device to poke your finger. These are the lancets to load into the lancing device. This is a quality control solution to calibrate the glucose monitor and test any new strips you get. Finally, this is a logbook to keep track of the blood glucose results and show them to your physician or other healthcare professional during your next visit.
When first using the meter, make sure the date and time of the blood glucose monitor is correct. This is to ensure that we have accurate data when tallying into the logbook. All meters have different settings for the time and date. On this meter, holding the M button will adjust date and time. The button on your meter may be different depending on the brand of your glucose monitor. Refer to the user manual for more instructions on your particular meter. Check the test strips container to confirm that the strips are not expired. Confirm that the batteries do not need replacing if the meter is not turning on.
Before starting, wash your hands with soap and warm water, then dry thoroughly. Now let's set up the Lancet device. Remove the lancing device end cap by twisting it to the right and unlocking it. This is where you will insert the lancet. Push the lancet in as far as it will go. Next, twist the circular cap off the lancet to expose the needle. Save the cap to use it later. Recap the lancing device by twisting the white part to the left until you hear a click. Some lancet devices differ in how to load the lancet. Refer to the instructions on your particular lancing device.
You will notice some numbers right here. Each number signifies how deep the needle will go into your finger when poking. The bigger the number, the deeper the needle will go. 2 or 3 is best for most people, but you can go higher if you have thick, calloused skin. For us, we will do a 3. Pull back the white bottom part to activate the needle. Now that it's ready, set it aside. Next, get your test strips. Stick the gray part all the way into the monitor, which will turn the monitor on. Depending on your monitor brand, you may need to press an on-off button. The other part of the strip is where the blood sample will be collected. Now, you are ready to poke your finger. You can rub your hands together to make them warmer and get more blood flow to the finger. It is better to use the side of the fingertip because it is less painful than the middle of the finger pad. pick up your Lancet device and push it hard against your fingertip. Press the white button on the device to poke the finger. Massage your finger towards the poked spot to obtain a drop of blood and apply it to the end of the test strip in the meter. It will take about 5 seconds for the monitor to give you the reading.
Record your blood glucose result in the logbook or on a paper with the date, time, and your blood glucose result. For the logbook, your healthcare professional will tell you how many times to measure your blood sugar and your specific goals depending on the time of day. For most people with diabetes, their blood glucose while fasting or before breakfast should be between 80 to 130 milligrams per deciliter. 2 hours after a meal, the goal is less than 180 milligrams per deciliter. But please confirm with your healthcare professional about your specific goals as they vary depending on the patient.
For the disposal of use supplies, pull the use test strip out of the monitor and toss it in the trash. Uncap the lancing device, and with the circular cap you kept from earlier, cover the needle. Push the lancet ejector on the side to dispose it off directly into a sharps container. You can get a sharps container from your pharmacy and can return it back when full. Reusing your lancet can make the needle blunt and cause more pain. It can also increase your risk of getting an infection.
In terms of storage, you want to store the meter in a cool, dry place. Clean the meter with a dry tissue only. Always keep the test strips in the airtight container that they came in. If you ever get an error reading on the monitor, refer to the user manual. The most common errors are when there is not enough blood on the test strip or the batteries need to be replaced. You can also call the manufacturer toll-free number listed on the back of the meter for assistance. Or bring the glucometer to your next clinic or pharmacy visit to ask for help.
Lastly, you should complete the product registration card. The card is usually in the glucose monitor box and looks like this. It is a good resource to receive information on product recalls, coupons, and diabetes management tools. I hope this was helpful in showing how to measure your blood sugar. Thank you.